And so he has a report to make on this special occasion. And the first item on the agenda is to declare that some people have been helped over these 38 years. I didn't say everybody had been helped. I said that some people, have really been helped over these 38 years. Here is a pool known for its miracle-giving powers. It is said that every year, at a certain time of the year, that an angel comes down. An angel came from God and stepped in the pool. And when the angel entered into the waters, there was a mighty, mysterious, and miraculous moving of the waters. And when the waters moved, the first person who stepped down in the pool was healed of whatever malady had afflicted him or her. Here we are tonight. We're here to give you a report, to say to you that there are some people who have been helped over these 38 years. The Bible says that in this gathering, around this pool where there were five porches or porticos, there was a great number of people who came regularly with high anticipation that if they were there on the best day, on the best day of the year, they would witness the moving of the water. And better than that, they would not only see something that is mysterious and miraculous, but if they were fortunate enough to be the first one in the water, whatever malady had afflicted them, they would be healed. And the record is that those who were there had various conditions of infirmity. The Bible says here that there were some blind folk there. The Bible says there were some who were maimed or where they were paralyzed. There were some lame folk there, and they had come. I choose to believe that these people didn't come just looking for some magic. I choose to believe that they had come to the pool because the pool had a pretty good reputation. And they came expecting to be blessed of whatever it was that they had. And they knew that if they were the first ones to get in the pool, a miracle would take place. And I tell you, my brothers and my sisters, that you and I and others may have come to the church even today for different reasons, but we ought not miss the fact that some people really come to get help. And that's the reason why we ought to be careful in how we conduct ourselves, both in conversation and conduct, in the way we behave ourselves in the house of God, because everybody's not here for form and fashion. Everybody's not here out of custom and tradition. Everybody's not here to see and be seen, but some people came today because they really need some help from above. And the church has to bear responsibility for so much of the foolishness that goes on in the name of the Lord. You don't hear what I'm trying to say. We sometimes criticize people who are sitting in the pews in the back because they talk about what's going on up in the front. But the truth of the matter is the way that we give them a performance, the way we give them a show, it is no wonder they don't talk back in the pews. Because you see, my brothers and sisters, people who come to the church with their minds on God don't come to be entertained. They don't come to see how slick and how polished that anybody can be on the program. There are some people who have deep spiritual needs. There are some people who need a healing in the body, or a healing in the mind, or a healing in the spirit, and they don't have time for our foolishness. Our Baptist foolishness. Sometimes we get so caught up answering questions that nobody's asking. that we've rendered ourselves irrelevant to a hurting constituency. We've already heard mentioned here today some hurting needs of young people that is pervasive in our community. And somebody ought to take time to think about what does it take to provide a good, strong role model for these young men who are influenced by all kinds of negative factors in the community. These who are here are our jewels. These who are here are our treasures. These who are here are our most valuable assets, because if the boys are destroyed, the race is destroyed. If the boys lose their hope, the church gets weaker. And there are some people in the church who really come because they need help. They're not caught off guard by who sends a solo. They're really not even impressed by who preaches a sermon, because they don't even know a sermon until they hear one. And if the church feels like it's a good sermon anyhow. But there are people who come with heavy hearts and hung down heads, and they need a lift. They don't need gossip. They don't need show-offs. They need somebody to let them know that there can be help for you and that the water will be moving. I think we ought to tell the church every now and then that the water is not moved on every song. That the water is not moved on every sermon. But you got to come and then come back and then come back and wait for God's time to work in your life. You can't do it just stopping in every now and then. You can't do it just by showing up on Mother's Day or somebody's funeral. But no, 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 you got to be here for the moving of the water. And I thank God that the water is still moving. And every now and then, there's evidence that the water is still moving. You see, the great blessings of Christ, the great miracles of God, are not always sensational displays. God is performing miracles for his people in ways that are sometimes unidentifiable. The Bible says they were waiting for the moving of the water. I don't know how many of you here tonight came because you wanted to see the water move. I mean, it wasn't that you came because you wanted to hear the choir sing or the preacher preach, or you didn't want to hear and see what kind of anniversary the pastor was getting, but because you needed the water move. And the people of Jesus' day believed in it because there evidently had been some actions earlier. And this pool became so important that they built porches around it. And they knew that everybody wouldn't go out rejoicing. Everybody wouldn't go out skipping and jumping. But when the water was moved, that meant an angel from heaven had come up from above. And when the water was moved, somebody got help. Somebody got healed. And you ought not forget, as the church of Jesus Christ, it is a house of mercy. You know why it's a house of mercy? Because the Lord let us come in. I don't mean no certain number over here in this corner or that corner or on the back row, but I'm talking about from the pulpit to the door. If we would be honest with ourselves, we would be able to stand and testify and tell others that yes, I'm here